again the live session of Decode Panda, and I hope you get to us all good. Okay, so today is an exciting day. Today is Sunday actually, and exciting day, and we are going to learn something new, which is a new library which eventually fascinates you, because we are going to learn about OpenCV. Okay, so what is OpenCV? We learn that what is OpenCV, how to use them. First of all, let me open my notepad so I can give you what you are going to learn in this complete live session. Okay, great. Let's start with writing what we are going to cover. Great. First of all, we are going to cover what is OpenCV. Okay, OpenCV is a library. I'm going to tell you what OpenCV and why I'm so excited about it. Okay, so then you get to know about OpenCV and you also feel excited. Okay, same like me. OpenCV. Second thing we are going to learn, which is we are going to learn about OpenCV. What is OpenCV? How to install it? How to work with that? And what OpenCV can perform? So OpenCV can use to do a lot of tasks, from capturing your window, capturing your camera, capturing yourself. It can create your video. It can create your you can do a lot of things. I am going to tell you about three applications we are going to discuss today. First application is we are going to make a face detector app or program using OpenCV library. Okay. Second thing we are going to do a program of edge detection. Why I choose edge detection? Because it's little bit important. Okay, edge detector app. So it will eventually open your camera, or it will take an image and it will find out all the edges in the image. Okay, I will show you that also. Okay, third thing is we are going to mask the background or remove the background. Okay, so when camera is open, or when you take an image and it has a background, it will remove the background. It will show you the foreground which you needed. Okay, so these are some tasks we are going to do in our live session, and also that we are going to cover OpenCV. So I think it's fantastic thing that in Python we have a library to perform image processing, okay, or I say video processing. Okay, you can create a video, you can process a video, or you can take an image and you can process it. So what a legendary type of software you can make from this library, using this library, or only this library. You can take some other library, you can take some machine learning applications, and you can make an application to detect, to recognize the faces. Okay, whenever you see some applications, okay, let me write some applications. Okay, some applications. For example, there is a program I have seen on internet where you can play your game using your hands by showing your hands in camera. Okay, so without touching any console or any button or any keyboard or any mouse, you just need to control your person or your game by using your own camera, by using your hand. Just move your hand and it will eventually control your player. Okay, that's it. This is a first application. Let me talk about the application, something called face recognition software. So every recognition software, you can make a face recognition software. Okay, what a pay sequencing software is, it can be a security software, it can be a gender classificator. You know, by seeing the image, it can classify between, cat and dog, or male or female, or object detection by using, machine learning algorithms. But you first need to understand the image. Whenever you want to recognize some image, right? You need a library to perform, take the input first, right? So whenever you are going to recognize between these two images, and you first need to recognize, you have to get the data, okay? Something like if a person, you want to recognize between cat and dog, you need to see these things from your eyes, then you can recognize the same thing. The eye concept perform, it will perform by a camera, and the library OpenCV helps it to focus on the input part. Okay, so when you see outside the world, you see a lot of things. If you see an image, you see a lot of things in image, but you focus on a cat or dog or picture you want to recognize. Same thing is when a camera is open, it captures everything, but how can it get a certain object from the image? Okay, a frame. Okay, so whenever you open a camera, it will take images in frame, and we have to recognize. So we have to recognize this by using a library. It is called as OpenCV, or I say Open Camera Vision. Sorry, Computer Vision. Open Computer Vision. The library name is Open Computer Vision. So basic vision software, some high-tech AI software, okay, which you can use to recognize something. Example of self-driving car. If they are using camera, okay, so they actually use the camera. Then they use camera to recognize, use camera to get the input. And in order to recognize a vehicle or detect a vehicle, this is a vehicle, we have to detect it, right? In that case, you need a language library, something which is eventually OpenCV. Okay? So that's the use of OpenCV. It's the starting point when you are entering in image processing task. There are lots of things in image processing task. It's a helpful library. So let's understand first our topic. Okay, what is OpenCV? Okay, it's our, what is OpenCV? This is our first task we are going to learn. So let's jump and on the browser and let's search for it, because I want to show you what is OpenCV. OpenCV is actually a C++ library. Okay, let's search on your browser OpenCV, and I will give you some what it means. So OpenCV. Here it is. OpenCV is a library of programming functions mainly aimed at real-time computer vision. So it is used to perform computer vision tasks. Okay, it is developed by Intel, and it is actually a C++ library. Then how can we programming language C++? But we have a phenomena. We have a library in Python by which we can use OpenCV in our own system. Right? Get it? Okay. So now you get to know about what is OpenCV. You get to know about what the application of OpenCV. What we can perform it. Let's install it, and then we will perform some tasks on it. Okay? And we will see how to use our lab. Okay. Minimize is what we have to do. First of all, you need to install ideally in your system, or Python in your system. This is compulsory, you have to install it. So I'm not going to tell you about how to install Python in your system. You may eventually know you, because to start this complete session, you have to know about Python little bit, okay? Then you can understand what's going on here. Okay, so let's go through and install a library. I'm going to also tell you how to install a library. Okay, first of all, open command prompt. So if you are in command prompt. Okay, yeah. If you are in Windows, it's good. If you are Windows lower than 10, right? If you are Windows 10, you can open Windows. You should open command prompt, or you can open Windows own something called Lightroom. Remember that. Okay, so let's jump on command prompt. Type Python. So, or you can type Python 3. So when you type Python, it shall begin to run. It means, yeah, we have Python 3.9.1 in our system. So if you seen my videos last about installing Python in Windows or Mac, whatever, you have seen that I have pushed you to check out the box of adding a path. Right, when you install, there's a step where you have to check the box, okay, so in order to add the path in your system. When you add path on your system, when you type here Python, it will eventually run your IDE. So let's exit it. It means we have our own, we have completed, we have Python at a correct path. Now it's time to install a library. First of all, we need to install NumPy. Why? Because whenever you perform some tasks, okay, when you perform some tasks in OpenCV camera task, you get an image. An image should be in matrix form. So you need to perform some NumPy task. Then need to be okay. So first of all, let's import NumPy. So how to install NumPy? It's so simple. Type pip install and library name. So this time library name is NumPy. Press enter and page to install it. So if you are using Anaconda, you have your own prompt box, okay, in Anaconda, and then you have to type conda install NumPy. It will take time, a lot of time actually. That's why I never use Anaconda type system. But if you have, that's also good. You can, it will take a time and install. I think yeah, Anaconda already have NumPy in Panda. Some libraries, it also have some libraries in pre-install libraries in Anaconda. Okay, so you need to install every library. So, and I think it's a bit tough to install OpenCV also. Search on Google if you have a problem. Just comment. Okay. All right. So we have installed NumPy. Now it's time to install OpenCV. So, put my back. Because it's a little bit tough to install OpenCV. Let's try. Python. Type Python dash m dash pip install OpenCV dash Python. Okay? Not on a Python. Openly with Python. Okay? Let's press enter. Let's see if it will install it or not. I hope it will install. Okay. It shows error. Python version none OpenCV. Python pip install. Let's type pip install OpenCV. Let's try this. So these are some commands. Okay. I think we have to Google it. Because I think the key would be changed. Okay. Let's have it. I search how to install. Okay, so you can find a lot of commands OpenCV installing in let's pip install OpenCV Python. Okay, this is, I think, command. This is PyPy library that we need. Okay, so we have command pip install OpenCV Python. Let's try this. And hope it will succeed. Usually don't play sure. Okay, let's wait. Install OpenCV dash Python. Okay, it starts installing Python in my system. Great, we found it. Great. Even C. Great. Great. Okay. So Python is installing in our system. We just have little bit help from Google. We search on Google how to install, and we get a pypy.org profile. We get a pip install of NCVS as Python. Okay. Sometimes install from. Okay. Okay. One more thing I have to remember. I get to one. OpenCV has two basic versions, OpenCV 2 and CV 3. So, and I never tried OpenCV 3, but I think OpenCV 2 is great. So I will start. Go ahead with CV 2. Okay. So let me wait to install everything, and it also try to install. When you don't need to install NumPy, if you don't have NumPy. It always try to satisfy, you know, download NumPy when you run this command. Okay, great. So we have now, we can just check whether we have every library or not. Python, and it will try to run your shell. Okay, now import, that's NumPy, import NumPy as np. Okay, short name np, shortcut import cv2. Okay, so okay, it will run correctly. It means we have everything installed and we are ready to go. Got the point. Okay, hope you get that. Okay, write this also command. Write this command also, because sometimes it runs, you know, some systems and sometimes don't. So you have to try a lot of things to install. Obviously, it's really tough. Okay, so we don't need this. Now back to the game. OpenCV installed. Okay. Come on desktop. Let's make a folder. Okay, because we have to save a lot of files here. Let's make a folder. Its name is image processing. Let's have it. Image processing. Okay, let's do the all task here. Okay. Now we have to make a file. Wait. Let's create a new file. Create a text document. We have text document. Now, right, let me write img1. Okay. So you can play with images, or you can play with your you can play with images. Okay. Or you can use your own camera to perform the real time task. We are going to perform the real time task. Okay. You can use your camera. Okay. Wait. So let's open it. If you don't know how to open like this, just I did, just go on ideally, okay. And when you are going to, you know, save, you can just select when you open a new file. When you are going to save it, okay, just select the right path you want and save as that. Okay. So I already have done that. On that, click on right side, that is it, ideally 3.9. Wait, we are ready to go. So first of all, let's import everything. Import numpy as np. Import cv2. Okay, wait. So we have imported our libraries. Now it's our turn to read. Okay, read the like you can perform a lot of tasks. First of all, let's have an image and let's try to read that. Okay. If you want to read some more thing about OpenCV, you can perform a lot. I think you can. Okay, on python.org. Okay, great. So let's have an image. Let's have an image. Sorry. Image. Let's have something image of a face. Image of a person. Okay. Someone. That's someone. Let's have this guy. This is smart. He looks smart. Great. You can find a lot of link to install, how to install Python OpenCV 3 on Windows. And that's right there. Okay. You can try 5-image search. This is a great website. You can learn, you can visit 5imagesearch.com and they will teach everything what to do. There are a lot of labs, websites and communities which teach people a lot of, okay, what, you know, you can learn from that. Wait, invisible. Okay, where is our, okay, so long here, we have got images now. Okay, we have images. Let's rename it as image 1. Yeah, let's have image and the code 1.jpg. Let's open that. Okay, it's good to make a folder and have image on the same folder because it's easy to read that, right? So let's start. Okay, let me make a simple program to read an image and to show the image. Okay, so let's call it a frame. Okay, let's read a frame. Okay, an image is a single frame, right? A video has a multiple frames. Okay, depends on the speed of the frame picture. Okay, how do you gonna catch it? Okay, let's read it. cv2.img and the path width. Let's see. Okay, so our image name is img_1.jpg. Image_1.jpg. Wait. Now let's show this image. cv2.im show and let's show the frame and should name us its image. This is the name of image on the title bar. Okay, show. Okay, so we have that image and we have to show the frame and then we have to write something called if cv2.wait key because we want to render the picture until we want. Wait key 1 if someone press the key, or if we press the and if we press the 0xff means is equal to ordq. It means it will try to compare ff keyword because when we convert this q word, if someone press q, okay, then it will wait key or q, then it will completely break the it will release. Okay, so we can do one more thing. We just use cv.wait key. okay, don't use that because we are not running a loop, so it's okay. And then we need to release cv2.destroy all windows. I think that works. Destroy all windows. Wait, let's save this and try to run it. To open an image, yeah, we have got that, right? You can easily get that. We have a warning also. cv2.cv2 has no module wait key. Okay, something went wrong. Okay, so we just do a little bit thing. We just read an image and we show the image. Okay, wait, we can also write the image. Okay, so let me write the image for you. cv2.write. Okay, write the path. Let's have image2.jpg. Okay, /frame. Okay, so we will make another copy of our program. Run module, save it. And I hopefully I will eventually able to make it. Let's see. We will get that image or not. Okay, wait here. So you can find out the exact same image we have already copied that, and you can see that the size will be increased. I don't know really. Okay, so we have an image, we read it, we show it, we write it. You can also modify it. Okay, how can we modify it? We can crop it, right? We can crop it, definitely we can crop it. We can make it anything we want. Suppose that we want to make a rectangle on over that. What? Let's make a rectangle. CV2 dot rectangle. Okay, we can make a lot of things. We can pick circle on where on that image or one, whatever you want. Frame, comma, that this is some point, the from where. Like suppose that we have an image that has image. And we want to make a circle from some point from, I don't know. Let's have this is 0.0, 0.0, and this is the last one. When we draw a circle, we have to give 2 points, okay? Like we have to draw like something like where can I draw? Okay, I'll go. Let's open paint and I will show you how to draw it and what I meant to say. Okay. So I want to say, when you want to make suppose a rectangle, you want to make a rectangle, right? We have to pass two values. This value, this is this value, left side upper and right side lower. So we have to pass these two values here at this point and this one, x and x comma y value and x comma y value. X comma value left upper side, x comma y right upper side. Let's see that. Okay. So let's pass it. Okay. So suppose that we want to make a rectangle from 100, 100 to 500, 500. Okay, and what its color will be? Let's say we have a BGR. Okay, make sure. Always remember, here we don't follow RGB, we follow BGR. Okay. Okay, let's see, we have blue color. One that, hopefully we get the blue color. Show, close this image, we don't need that. And we have image. You can clearly see, B, and we get a blue screen, okay? We get a rectangle over there, okay? On a frame. And eventually I think I also write this frame. So I get the image with a frame in that. So you can take the image, you can modify it, and you can again rewrite it, right? Make a copy of that with modified that. You can make a lot of things. So let's do a little bit thing. Okay, let's perform a third task. Let's mask the background. Let's try to mask the background. Okay. Let's mask the background. Okay. So for masking the background, we have to use a background subtractor. Okay. Let's start. First of all, we get the frame, right? We get the frame. Now, after getting the frame, we have to make the something called like foreground subtractor. Okay, something. Okay, CV2 has a function called create background. Okay, subtractor. It's a function. Okay, you can find on internet. Because I don't get that too. MOG2. Okay, this is. We get the point, we have created our function object here. So we have got that. Now it's time to create the image and change the image. Okay, so let's do that. Okay, So we get the image. Now it's time, let's remove this. Okay, and not show, not remove this because I'm not want to write it. Okay, okay, I think it's shown weight here because K is should be capital. I think that's why it's showing every time we run it. Okay, warning, K should be capital. Actually missed that out. Okay, let's do this. Let's make a foreground mask equal to apply this. Okay, svg dot apply and apply on frame. We have seen this on the foreground mask main image. Let's have a copy paste it. So this is our original image without mask, original image, and this is our updated image. Let's see the change, save it, try to run it, and we eventually see the two images. This is our original image and this is our original image, this is our updated image. You can see the, you can clearly see the difference actually, because there is a white background. I hope that's the one problem with that. It's not good enough. Yeah, I think it's not good enough to have to remove the background. And then everything correctly. Okay. We'll try it on, we try this thing on our own, demo. Okay, let's perform the task. Main task. Detect phase. Okay, so for detecting phase, let's remove everything we have written till now. First of all, you need a something called hair cascade wall. There are various ways to detect a face. There are, I think, three algorithms to detect face. We are going to use a hair cascade file. So go on internet, search for HAARR hair cascade file. Okay, so you get a file. Okay, so there are different files. You can download it. Okay, on GitHub you can find a lot of images. Hair cascade file for everything, for getting a person's image, for face, for eyes, for capturing a face smile, for capturing a bright color. Get a lot of it. Okay, so when you come here, like this, you can see OpenCV data and hair cascade. Someone is sharing this complete hair cascade file. You can get your own hair cascade file. But for now, we are going to copy the given one. Okay. So we have given eye tree with eye skull glasses, frontal face extended, frontal face alternative, alternative 2, 3, default, full body, left eye. These are files. XML file. These are XML files. Sorry. We use frontal face XML files to detect a person's face in a given picture. Right? Wait. So you can get upper body, Russian plate number, right eye. There are different stuff. You can find a lot of hair cascade files on that. Let's have a frontal face file. Okay? For now. So it will create, if we create, or we can download it. Let's see what we can perform. Okay. Oh no, wait. Don't. Okay, just copy that. Missed the file. I need to file right now. Has open quotes issues pull request. Let me go back. Just try to get that file first, and then we are going to perform the task. Okay, so I think we have file. There should be option for copying the entire project, entire file. No, do it manually. There should be. The file is too long. I know this file is too long. Too long. Okay, it's better to download that. I hope I already have done that. So let me check on my system where I have in my working task, and we should have, yeah, we have our cascade frontal base default. Okay, so let's copy that in our folder on desktop. We have made a folder name as we have a frontal base. Okay, I can get by. You can download it from the internet. That's not an issue. You can copy that if you want, or there are a lot of websites where you can find it. Good. Back to the game. We have our cascade file on our system. Let's get started. So we have imported NumPy. We have imported CV2. Let's import face file. What we have already downloaded. cv2.cascade.classifier, so it is actually classifier file. Okay, it's classifier, cascade classifier. Okay, correct spelling. Okay, let's copy this entire file's name and paste here. Wait, we have done that. Now we read the image. Okay, so id.read and then read our image. So you can just do like that, or you can just remove read. Okay, doesn't matter. So let's read cv2.im. Read, let's read the image. We already have image under 1.jpg. We have frame now, we have face file now. We have to convert our image into gray image, you know, black and white thing, because it's good to convert it on gray scale rather than using colored image. So let's have it cv2.cvt color, then frame, comma cv2.color. Sorry, color should be capital. Okay, color underscore bgr to gray. So we have converted our image to gray. Now get faces. Faces, basically we have a simple face. So now we apply our cascade file on our grayscale image or frame. Okay, let's have face file, apply that face file dot bit text multiscale. This is a function in face file. So detect multiscale, and then frame, first parameter is frame, second parameter is the size, third parameter is how much you want. That's 3 maximum faces you can detect, and 1.3 is a value from 1 to I think 1.5, maximum 1.5 is the size from which it captures the images. Let me explain thoroughly. Okay, so if it gets any image, a face is greater than 0, then we make a rectangle around that. Okay, so if we get that, okay, so for now let me get all the faces from the image, x y point, and then its width and its height, where you get the image. in space. And we, you know, pop out all spaces one by one. Let's have CV2 dot rectangle. Let's make a rectangle around that, rectangle around our original image. Okay, you can make on gray, but we want to show the original image. We pass x, y, these values, like these values, and this, adding these values too. So x, comma y, comma x plus, you know, x plus width, w, comma y plus height, right? Wait. Then let's pass this image. Let's write the, you know, what color of rectangle around the face we want, and then, yeah, then we have get that right. Now wait, let's make the images. Okay, let's show the image. Because we have a single image, we need to show it. I am show, and then let's show the image. Okay, let's write updated one and save. If you want, you can make a copy of original frame, and then you can paste original one and update view. Okay, then use cv2.wait key, and k should be capital, right? Value should be 0 or 1, whatever you want. Okay, then we need to destroy windows. cv2.destroy all windows. So whatever windows you have opened, it will destroy after then complete profile. Okay, let's save it, try to run it. See, we change the image, it will get or not. I am read image one, too many values to unpack. There are too many values we need to unpack. I think that's the problem. Okay, so you can clearly see we got the image and we got the face also. Bye. Right, it's a good. Let's have an image also. Image with multiple faces. Okay. So we can draw an image around that. So let's have something like this. Capture the image. Wait, just a minute. Let's download this image. Doesn't matter what the quality of the image. It will be great if you have it nice and, you know, higher pixels. It will easy to detect that. Close everything here and paste that. We have 4 images, right? So let's not change the name, download.jpg. So we need to change this value, because we are getting 3 faces, maximum 6 faces. Now we want 5 faces, maximum. And let's change the image. So it is download.jpg. Wait, let's run that. And we will eventually succeed. Okay, let's make the image bigger. It will only able to get a one face, frontal face, because of, I think, frontal face. We can't get this face because this person has glasses. We need to use another library. Okay, and I don't know why it's not these two people. Let's change the value. Okay, let's change the value of this 1.3 to 1.1. let's try to make it will eventually take time, I think. That will get the image fine. Yeah, that by changing the value from 1.3 to 1.1, we can get the value. What that means? What's the meaning of this one? You know, you can get the point by 5 is maximum faces you want. 1. What is the value of 1.1? It's a variation from 1 to 1.5. What is the value? What it does? Let's see that. Okay. So let's open any research that. Okay. So what eventually does it? Let's have this is because you must get. When you choose value from 1, okay, so it will pass the image like this, like in short order. It will took some small frame, find out the image. It will took some small frame and find it again and again and again, passing the all pixels. It cover all the pixels in small fraction. Okay, when it took the value of as 1.5, it will took the number of pixels as much as greater. So if it took this image, okay, like if you divide this image in 4 sections and we took only 1 section, we never get the image, right? We never get this image. If it took small pixels, then it's hard to get it. So it will eventually, you need to just tweak around the value of this parameter to get the value. Okay, so if it choose the this same value in previous value, can we get the image? Let's see that. Okay, so we need 3 images, it doesn't matter, 1.1. Let's see that. Try to run it again. Okay, so yeah, we are able to get that. Right? We are able to get that. Hopefully, if we perform, we change the value from 1.3 to 1.1 to 1.5 or 1.3 or 1.1. Hopefully we get the images more precious. So if you want, if you, your faces are too small, choose this value smaller. If you choose this value as smaller, it will take more time to process, but it gives you the precision answer. Okay, that's it. So this is our second task. Now last not least task, we use edge detection. Okay. So for using edge detection, I don't think we have to perform a lot of things. We need to just change the little quick thing, and that is we have to perform a simple thing. So we have frame, we have updated frame. Let's have CV2 dot edge. Let's get edges equal to CV2. Dot canny, okay, and then have frame, okay, and the frame are, you know, these frames are these complete frames are updated one, right? We use updated one frames, okay, to make sure that, okay, and let's make this also, okay, to make it easy. So easy to make the images as steady. Okay, let's print edges and then update it to one or update it to save that. Try to run it. And we have image. Canny is missing a requirement argument dy. So we have missed some parameters. Okay, I think I've seriously missed some parameters. Frame and its size, some you know, you need to pass some variables to run that. Okay, let's try to run that and it will make our image as canny. You can see that we have image which is updated, which will show the images. This is our original image. You can close that. This is our image in which we have make our edges. So these two values, 100 and 200, show the important aspect to take how much image edges you want. Okay, so that's it. That's all we have learned. We have learned what is OpenCV, how to use OpenCV to open images, show images, and save images again in system. We have seen face detection in OpenCV using HiCascade file. You also detect different things like. You need to make your own HiCascade file, or maybe in some other tutorial, or I make a complete release on OpenCV. I'll show you how to make a complete Her kitchen by your own. Okay? And then we have learned agitation using a single cv2.canny function in which we have passed some parameters and will show the edges. So it's so simple. You can perform a lot of things using image processing OpenCV, like pasting one image on another image, or subtracting an image from a complete image. You can perform anything you want, okay? But you need to learn deeper. You have to learn this library in a deeper way. So, okay? So I think it's good to start with OpenCV for a basic purpose, and then you will learn a lot. Okay? So that's it for the class. Hope you get that. Okay? Thank you for being with us, and let us know that you want a series on this complete system or not. Okay? So until then, thank you for being with us, and bye-bye.